everyone, Rick here, and folks, welcome to VLOG-O-WEEN Day 17. We got a lot going on today, so today, when I'm recording this, is Thursday, October the 12th, which means that's right, tomorrow, Friday, is the 13th! So I actually did take tomorrow off of work, so we got a nice 3-day weekend to ourselves this weekend. We got some plans for sure, but we also got in the mail a couple of packages. Folks, those are filled with some of the greatest, latest board gaming has to offer. So we'll definitely be taking a look at that. We got some storms rolling in as well, so we may have to take a peek at how the storms are doing, how the Halloween decorations hold up to those storms. Let's see, what else? And then now we are headed to go get some dinner. Let's find out where. All right, folks, as you may have seen, that was Olive Garden. So I just had some dinner at Olive Garden. Oh my gosh, folks, I swear it is so good. You see on social media all the time, people have something against these casual dine-in restaurants. Oh my God. It's not like they're coming into your kitchens and forcing you to eat their food. It's not like it invalidates your home cooking, Cheryl. I mean, anyway, sorry. I could go on and on because I see these complaints all the time and it is so good. When's the last time these people have actually had this? If you saw what I got, that chicken gnocchi soup, oh my gosh, that's a top 5 soup for me, period. Oh my goodness, it is so freaking good. And then I got the ravioli carbonara. How can you not like that? That is like big round, they call them raviolis, but they're just big stuffed pasta filled with cheese in this cream sauce with bacon and more cheese. Oh my gosh, it is so good. I mean, who cares if, you know, their big claim to fame in the kitchen is heating things up in a microwave? That's what I would do at home anyways. So if, and nothing that you can get in the freezer section and then microwave yourself at home tastes anything like that. All right, anyways, beyond that, we just, I don't know if you can see, we just are leaving Panera now. We just stopped in there for our Sip Club iced coffee. And what else? I was thinking about going to Office Depot again, actually, because I was thinking about picking up some sheets for the printer that are address labels so I could print off address labels because I'm doing Halloween cards this year. That got a big response. So a lot of people were interested in getting a Halloween card from me. So I have all these addresses, and instead of writing them all out by hand, I was hoping I could maybe print them out. So, but I'm not so sure if I'm in the mood to go shopping for address labels right now. We did pick up a bunch of things on Amazon. Did I record last night's outro before or after I did that? Probably before. I bought a gaming chair on Amazon. I bought earbuds, a new set of earbuds on Amazon. I bought some earbud tip replacements on Amazon, and I bought some earbud cord extension cables on Amazon too. So I got a big Amazon package coming. But anyways, my original plan for dinner while I was at work today was just gonna run somewhere fast to pick up something and come home so that I could get to unboxing those games. But I did decide to go to Olive Garden, which was a wonderful idea. It was so delicious. Everything was fantastic. I had 3 refills of Dr. Pepper. The waiter was on point with those refills. I had 2 bowls of soup. Oh, it was so good. But now let's get the heck home so we can unbox these games. All right, folks, just wrapped up my main gaming channel unboxing video of my packages, one of which came from Board and Dice, which included my copy of Nucleum with the pre-order promos. So that is absolutely fantastic. And then the other package from Game Nerds, absolutely packed brilliantly, as always. Go check out my actual unboxing video to see how well it was packaged. And this was a tale of two packages, right? Because this huge box, and it may be foreshadowing how you can kind of see this corner's a little bit crumpled on the actual shipping box, where the game itself was wrapped in this lighter bubble wrap and topped with this crumbled up paper. So you can imagine a box that was probably 4 times too big for a single game, with light bubble wrapping and some paper, ended up getting pretty crumpled up in this corner. And I don't even know if the, look at that. It just is like almost mush up here. But also the wrinkles, the ripples from the corner, like cut across the front of the box. So yeah, the box is kind of smushed up there. But I'm not one of those people who go, I need a new box. I need a replacement box. No, I totally get it. A publisher cannot afford to replace every box. All I can say is please, publishers, make sure that the packaging protects the box as best you can. But no, I'm going to enjoy the game regardless if the box has this unsightly blemish in the corner. On the other hand, game nerds who ship their package like it's holding a newborn child, just with all of this thick bubble wrap, there is not a space for these games to move. And of course, if the box was crumpled on a corner, I don't even know. I was going to say if it was crumpled on a corner, how's the game corner could still get hit. But like they cover all of the corners too in bubble wrap. So I don't know. I just have a feeling if Nucleum was shipped by Game Nerds, that would not have happened. And I don't care how far the shipping had to take place because Nucleum came from Europe, I believe. Whereas these just came from, you know, somewhere else here in the United States. But and obviously with these boxes from Game Nerds, not a blemish, not a crunch corner, nothing. But these were the games. Oh, so excited. First of all, for Nucleum, that is going to be one of my most anticipated games of the year. Simone Luciani, who did Golem and Teletum or Teletum, one of my it was my favorite game of 2022. So I'm very excited about this. And then these three, The White Castle, one of my favorite games of all time, is of course The Red Cathedral. So that, by the same designers, is super exciting. The Shake That City is going to be interesting, to say the very least, with this gizmo mechanic that you push the tab in and it drops some of these cubes out here, and you choose which ones, which will lead to placing the tiles, and you get points based on where the buildings are in the city and landmarks and things. Looks very interesting. But I was also really excited for Point City because Point Salad is fantastic. I think a lot of people love that game more than I do. I really like it, but it's like, okay, veggie or points, couple veggies or points, I should say. And it is interesting to see where your score ends up, but this just looks so good. Picking the cards out of this grid. Are you going to grab resources? Are you going to grab buildings? And then are you going to spend the resources to build the buildings? I mean, that just looks fantastic. So those were the games in the packages. All right, folks, and that'll do it for today's installment of VLOG-O-WEEN. I hope that you potentially may have caught my gaming live stream on my gaming channel where I was unpunching and bagging all of those games. I was gonna take some footage afterwards of the big, huge, empty sprue pile, but I forgot. But anyway, so that'll do it for us tonight. Thank you all so much for watching. I do appreciate it, and until next time.